up, Fabs and Besties?
The winter break has officially ended, and it's back to school and work. Which gives me an idea. In 2014, we made a doll classroom. It was pretty large. I'm not gonna pretend like storage wasn't an issue, but it was the set that we used for Sophie and Chloe's classroom scenes. Now that Summer and Callie are in college, let's make a college classroom in a hidden doll room. For this project, I'm using a tan foam board, scrapbook paper, cardstock, chalkboard paper. I got this at Michael's a while ago, so if you can't find chalkboard paper, you can always go with black cardstock. And I'm gonna use some felt for carpet. This foam board measures 20 by 30 inches. Measure up 13 inches. Cut on the line to get a 13 inch piece and a 7 inch piece. This room is going to need 4 walls, which means we will need another piece of foam board. On this 30 inch piece, we will be able to fit 3 of the walls. I flip it over to the other side, measure over 10 inches from the edge, score a line, repeat on the other side to make a trifold. I cut a 10 by 13 inch piece from another piece of foam board, glue it onto the end, making a corner, creating a box room that can fold up for easy storage. I need to cut a floor that is 9 3/4 inches, just about, and 20 inches long. I cut it from the second piece of foam board. I scored a line at 9 1/4 inches, so it will be able to fold up. Glue it into the corner, being sure not to glue down this part here so that it can lay flat and fold up. Yeah, I did get a little sloppy with my glue in that corner, but it's okay, we should be able to cover it up. Draw a line 4 1/2 inches from the wall, cut and glue together leftover foam board to make a platform. I cover with felt. For carpet, cut a piece of scrapbook paper, glue it onto the wall above the floor, cut leftover foam board into thin strips, glue them around the paper to make a door. We can also cut out a small opening to make a little window. I glue on a picture hook. For a doorknob, I cut the black chalkboard paper and glue it onto the farthest wall. Cut strips of cardstock. Stack and glue a few layers together. I have 2 wide strips, one where I added some thinner strips to it, and 4 thin strips. Paint them silver. Glue them around the chalkboard. Glue the wider pieces on the bottom to make a ledge. On a piece of paper, I sketch out a seat design, cut it out, use it as a pattern to trace more. I drew 6. It might be kind of hard to see, but we're gonna go ahead and cut them out. I have a total of 6, and we're gonna stack and glue 2 together. While the glue is still wet, we're gonna just bend it. Then add the other layers to make the seat of our chair. And when this dries, it should be fairly sturdy. For the legs, I'm using a 12 gauge wire. This is pretty easy to bend, which means our chair will be a little delicate, but I'm mostly confident that it will hold the weight of the doll. I start by bending one piece going straight across. Then we're gonna bend it back and then go up like that. Then we can go across, down, across, and up. Now I do need to take some time to make sure it's even and straighten all this out. Glue it underneath. I used a generous amount of hot glue to make the chair, and it works so far. Let's add a doll. Woohoo! It didn't fall apart. I think we can fit about 4 chairs in this space, so let's make some more. To try and keep them somewhat uniform, I drew a pattern for the wire to make the rest of the chairs. You know what? We could fit 6 chairs in this space, but I kind of wanted a little area that looked like they were walking up steps, so I stopped at 4. Then we can just add a little foam board going across to make a desk. This is probably a little too thick. Cut the foam board down to size, cover the top with a little tape. I cut a 4-inch piece of foam and a 2-inch piece to glue onto the ends to make the desk. We can glue them in place or just keep them freestanding so we can move them around. We just have to make sure the wall can still fold up. And since we put a frame around the door, we do need to be careful when we lay it down as well. We need a podium, so I'm cutting 7-inch rectangles of foam board. I have 1 3-inch piece and 2 1.5-inch pieces. Out of more foam board, I cut a 4 by 3-inch base, a 2-inch shelf, and then a small piece to go at the bottom of the shelf. Glue the larger rectangles together. I cover the outside with paper. I covered the 2-inch piece with the same paper, and I glued it in at an angle. Take the base, add the same felt that we used for the floor, glue it into the bottom. I was going to glue this in front, but I'm thinking we should use a piece of paper instead because this looks a little thick. I cut a few layers of cardstock to glue together, then glue it onto the edge to make a little lip to catch a book or pieces of paper. I'm not loving those edges, and after the way this came out, let's cover them with more strips of black paper to make a podium for the room. Now for me, this is pretty much what a college classroom looked like when I was in college. The classrooms were pretty basic. I mean, you were lucky if you got tan walls. A lot of my classrooms were white, maybe light gray, with no posters or anything on the walls. But sometimes you would see a little bit of architecture. So maybe we can add some leftover foam board on this wall, or maybe even thin strips of scrapbook paper. Then glue them onto the walls. I went with white foam board because we already had it going around the door. Let's write on the chalkboard. I am using chalk markers. Add our printable college textbook. Then I decided it was more important to have a longer desk than a few steps, so I ripped them out and glued in longer desk. I did have to patch the wall a little, but now we can easily fit 6 chairs in this space when I get around to making 2 more. And I grabbed our blue college textbook just because it seems to go with this space better, completing our college classroom or lecture hall, whatever you want to call it, in a hidden doll room. This is a pretty tight space. It does take a little bit of maneuvering to get them into their seats, but the base on the podium makes it easier for the doll to stand so they can teach the class. And since this wall opens, we can get some different camera angles that will make filming a lot of fun. Thank you for joining us while we made a doll classroom in a hidden doll room. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell. Follow us on Instagram at MyFroggyStuff and the Frog Vlog. And we will see you next time. Bye!